Well, a senior U.S. defense official tells me the president made the decision to pull out of Syria after speaking with Turkish President Erdogan last Friday, December 14th. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo was there at the time and was the first to be told, "We are leaving." The Turkish president told President Trump that Turkish forces were planning to enter Syria soon to go after the Kurdish PKK and warned U.S. troops to get out of the way. This, I am told, hastened the president's decision, something he had been mulling for some time. The president gave the military 30 days to pull out. The fear among U.S. military commanders and Pentagon chiefs is that the U.S. will not be able to protect its Kurdish and Syrian allies. The Syrian Democratic Forces, or SDF, who have fought alongside U.S. forces to defeat ISIS and retake Raqqa, those Kurdish forces and other allies are likely to be slaughtered, I'm told. As one senior U.S. defense official put it to me, no one will ever work or fight with us in the Middle East again as a result of this hasty withdrawal and the abandonment of those Kurds who risked everything to fight with the U.S. against ISIS. Not a single U.S. military commander or leader I've spoken to at the Pentagon agrees with the president's unilateral decision to pull all 2,000 U.S. troops out of Syria, leaving a vacuum that Iran and ISIS will fill. The decision is being viewed by the military as a Christmas gift to Russian President Vladimir Putin, who just spoke in Moscow during his annual news conference.
As for the Islamic State group defeat, I agree with the President of the United States. I have already spoken about the fact that we have achieved significant changes in the fight against terrorism on this territory and have seriously hit ISIS in Syria.
Most believe the Russians will move into the vacuum created by the U.S. pullout. The Russian embassy in Washington tweeted the following praise for President Trump's decision, quoting the spokesperson for Russia's Ministry of Foreign Affairs, quote, "The U.S. decision to pull its troops from Syria creates good prospects for a political solution in that Arab country." Critics point to the pullout of U.S. troops from Iraq in 2011 as giving rise to ISIS. Defense Secretary Mattis and John Bolton convinced the president to keep American troops on the ground in Syria, not only to continue the ISIS fight, but to keep an eye on Iranian forces in Syria. The president's announcement shows he is no longer listening to the generals, Defense Secretary Mattis, or Secretary Pompeo. Julie?
All right. Jennifer Griffin, thank you.